to us from all over the world. And I want to explain a few things to you real quick. This is what, honestly, 2 years ago or so now, I had the opportunity to go speak at the Cancer Treatment Center in Tulsa, Oklahoma, one of the leading cancer treatment centers in the country. And the chief of staff invited me to come in and speak to them, the oncologist there, probably because they couldn't comprehend why people from all over the world would come to a chiropractor in Knoxville, Tennessee, of all places. And just in all reality.
Yeah.
Why would it be that people from, for instance, a year ago we had a gentleman come in with stage 4 bone marrow cancer. Been on low doses of chemo radiation for 6 years.
Oh my God.
Stage 4 bone marrow cancer. Came into our office within 6 weeks. His platelet count had normalized, and the oncologist wrote healed on his paperwork. He's never been back since. How is it possible that people with MS and Parkinson's and Alzheimer's coming from all over the country and get out the medications and the brain function? I mean, we had someone recently that came in. He's completely blind since 3 years of age. He's probably 55. I don't want to guess his age, but 55 is a great man. He just can't see. He's completely 100% blind. His optic nerves were severed when he was 3. Came into our office and laid hands on him the first time, prayed over him and adjusted him. And for the first time in 50-some years, he started getting eye movement. The next time he came in, I prayed over him and adjusted him, and he started seeing flashes of light. And I know he'll be completely restored. You see some crazy things take place from all over the world. But what I'm going to share with you over, I'm going to take 10 minutes if this is okay. I want to explain to you really truly how the body works. And this is what the oncologists were blown away by. This is what, when I go to speak to doctors and medical doctors and chiropractors around the world, they're blown away by. I would take notes. I would encourage you to do that. Because what I'm going to share with you is revelation on how the body works that you will not get out there. You're not getting your medical doctor guaranteed, and you won't even get it in most chiropractors' offices. But if you can grasp this, what I'm going to share these 10 minutes, all this nutrition will make more sense to you than ever before, because you will have a foundation to build upon. We have a mentality in America, in our culture, that says if you feel good, you're healthy, right? Not broke, don't fix it. Feel lousy, then you go to the doctor. But how many of you know someone who's felt great and died of a heart attack and felt great and has cancer? All of us. So if health is about feeling good, those people won't die, but they do all the time. We have another mentality that says our health is based on our genes or genetics. How many of you have heard that before? It's just in your genes, they say. Well, it's true that I get the DNA from my mother and the DNA from my father. But even the geneticists today, and the epigeneticists specifically, will tell you that health has nothing to do with how you feel and nothing to do really even in your genes, but everything to do with how the gene code expresses itself in what they term gene expression. They said if you want to be truly healthy, simply make sure the gene code is expressing itself the way it's supposed to. They said that's based on 2 factors. Number 1, your external environment, the food that you eat and the air that you breathe. For instance, if we have a pond next door and one day we go out to that pond and all the animals are dead on that shoreline, would you assume the problem to be the DNA of those animals or the environment they were living in?
Environment.
Near me in Knoxville, Tennessee, there's a place called Oak Ridge, and Oak Ridge National Laboratories, where they created parts for the atomic bomb. It is proven in the structure at Oak Ridge, there's asbestos poisoning in the infrastructure and the insulation and so forth. So much so that many of the individuals got asbestos poisoning and affected genetic expression, and they, as a result, got cancer. I know a number of individuals that worked at Oak Ridge National Laboratory just in a cubicle and got cancer as a result of an external stress affecting genetic expression. They're no longer with us today. They died. And actually, the federal government will pay for their cancer treatment because it's proven asbestos is an environmental stress causing cancer. I also know individuals that sat right next to that individual in an environment with asbestos poisoning actually for 30 years. Knew each other very well. Family, friends. This individual here gets asbestos poison, dies of cancer, yet this individual works there for 30 years in an environment with asbestos poisoning, but never gets cancer. How is that possible? How is it possible that a marathon runner eats only organic, exercises every day of their life, drops out of a heart attack at 29, yet George Burns over here lives to be 300, smoking stogies and drinking beer? Now it's true that external stress is a causative factor in gene expression, but the number one causative factor in gene expression, according to leading geneticist today, is actually your internal environment. Specifically, they tell us your brain's ability to communicate with your body at a cellular level. They said, if you truly want to be healthy, simply make sure the brain, body, are communicating at a tissue cell level. So let's break this down a little bit. We believe, at least in our office in Nashville, Tennessee, that we're fearfully and wonderfully made, bought with a price, and God doesn't create junk. That seems to be a foreign concept in our society, that we're creating the image and likeness of God, but we actually believe that. The body was actually created to work. Crazy, foreign concept in our society. We come from two cells, an egg from our mother and a sperm from our father. Those cells come together, they begin to replicate, and at roughly 18 days of replication, they have replicated enough to form your brain. Why? Because your brain will run your body. Your brain will produce 65 trillion chemicals a second, and then it will communicate to your body, and your body consists of 80 trillion tissue cells, give or take a few. Every cell in your body must be in communication with the brain. If it is, it will vibrate. The vibration allows the cell to vibrate, allows the DNA or the gene code to express itself according to the geneticists. The quantum physicists, when they're adding the equations, they tell us this, that every cell in your body must be in communication with the brain in order for it to vibrate. And the vibration is what allows the gene code to express itself like the geneticists talk about. As long as the brain is communicating effectively, that cell will maintain its integrity and express the DNA the way it's supposed to. But if the brain ever loses communication at a cellular level, that cell loses its vibration and the gene code becomes altered. What's another name for abnormal cell growth?
Sickness,
cancer, disease, MS, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, you name it. Is an absence of life at a cellular level affecting cellular vibration, genetic expression? Our goal in our office is to make sure the brain and body communicate at a cellular level. That's foundational. That's step one. I can have the best exercise and nutrition in the world, but if I don't have the brain communicating at a cellular level, we got big issues. So the brain runs the body. The spinal cord is the lifeline to help communicate with the organs, tissues, and cells. Around the brain is the skull to protect it, and around your spinal cord is a vertebral column to protect your spinal cord. Between the vertebrae, though, there's a disc. The disc is fluid-filled. It's a shock absorber. It allows for motion to occur, but the biggest function of the disc is it keeps the vertebrae apart so the nerve supply can sit right behind it. So how the body works is that the brain sends light down the spinal cord, out the nerve endings, to the tissue cells so they can vibrate and express that DNA properly. Does that make sense to you how the body works?
Yes.
Now it gets interesting. Where we come in our office in Knoxville, Tennessee, which is unique from anywhere else in the world, really, is that our focus is not the vertebrae, like most chiropractors. Our focus is the outer layer of this spinal cord called the dura. How many of you have heard that doesn't work? How many of you have heard of the dura before? If you've had an epidural, that's what they're piercing. The dura is the skin on the spinal cord. It comes and wraps around the brain underneath the skull. It's a protective barrier. Separates the brain from the skull, the spinal matter from the vertebral column. Why is Dr. Oz talking about the dura? Why are the leading oncologists and quantum physicists and geneticists talking about the dura? People come into my office all the time and say, Dr. Pete, guess what Dr. Oz was talking about? I said, actually, I don't know, I actually work.
Exactly.
They said Dr. Oz was talking about headaches and the dura. They're talking about MS and the dura. Talking about Parkinson's. Why would the oncologists be talking about cancer and the dura? Because what they're finding is that the dura is the significant factor that determines the health of an individual. The dura is, like I said, the skin on the spinal cord. It comes and wraps around the brain. The dura is supposed to be relaxed like a rubber band in my hand. If the dura is relaxed, the brain will communicate with the cells at the speed of light. What stress does, though, is it stretches that dura, like a rubber band, it twists it. And when that spinal cord stretches, the body's now in a position to adapt physiologically, for instance. Let's go on a field trip. Let's say, for instance, we're at the zoo because it's going to be a beautiful week, and we love the zoo, and I think they have a good Como Zoo not too far from here in Minnesota. So let's go to the Como Zoo. We're having a good time enjoying each other's fellowship, and all of a sudden, tiger gets out. What happens? I don't know about you, but me, I'm going to take off. Male or female, young or old, we're going to run for our lives, correct? If a tiger is chasing us at the zoo, we're going to run like never before. Women will probably run right over us men because a tiger is chasing us at the zoo. But we're able to run like never before because the spinal cord will stretch. If it doesn't stretch, we're dead meat. But because it stretches, our pupils will dilate. Why? Because our body starts to adapt physiologically. In fact, when the spinal cord stretches, it's what allows the body to adapt physiologically. My heart rate will go up, my blood pressure will go up, and my digestive system will shut off. Why?
Because
if I'm running away from a tiger, I don't need to digest food. My immune system will shut off as well. Why? Because when in a stress response, my immune system will always shut down. Have you ever been in times of great stress? Maybe you don't get enough sleep the way you're supposed to, and you find that you get sick a little bit more frequently. Why? Because in a stress response, the immune system shuts off, the digestive system shuts off. Does that make sense to you? When they cage the tiger, though, the spinal cord recovers, which allows the body to come back to normal, or what we call homeostasis. Here's the issue. When stress affects us, physical, chemical, emotional, or spiritual, our spinal cord stretches and the stress goes away and it recovers. Here's the issue. If stress ever affects us, it is not dealt with properly, physical, chemical, emotional, or spiritual stress, and it's left there too long, the spinal cord will stretch as it's supposed to, but if it's left there too long, calluses will begin to form, called dural adhesions, adhesions to that dirt. Just like everyone in my backyard began to shovel, after a while I get calluses on my skin. I actually don't have calluses on my skin because of my wife's dismay. I don't actually shovel in my backyard. But if a callus forms on the spinal cord will no longer recover. That means I can put the tiger back in the cage, put you on a beach somewhere with no stress in your life, and your body will still assume it's running away from a tiger. My friends, that's the reason people feel good and die of heart attacks, feel good and have cancer. The body adapted physiologically and never recovered. Every time stress affects us, it stretches the dura. Stress is what it affects that dura, and if a callus forms, we got a serious issue. Here's what we now know. When the spinal cord stretches, it releases a chemical called nociceptors. Nociceptors are simply a chemical to the brain that tells the brain, hey, guess what, brain? You're running away from a tiger, so to speak. You're in a stress response. If I'm running away from a tiger, I need my brain to receive nociceptors, so I stay in a stress response. Are you in agreement?
Yes.
I need my body to adapt physiologically, and so when the spinal cord stretches, nociceptors are released to the brain to keep my body in that stress response. But when they cage the tiger, the spinal cord relaxes, the body releases what's called proprioceptors that stimulate the brain to stop the stress response and bring the body back to normal. Exercise releases proprioceptors. That's why you feel good when you exercise. It stops the stress response. Here's the issue. If a callus forms on the spinal cord because stress has been there for too long, the body will always cycle back into nociception. Means the exercise is good. That's great. But if it cycles back to nociception, you're stuck in a stress response. What affects this and counts for is stress. On our synergy calls, we've been talking about the great cholesterol myth.
Yeah.
And how there's medical doctors, heart surgeons, cardiologists that have come out to say this. They said high cholesterol, though the media has got us to believe, the cardiologists have got us to believe that high cholesterol causes heart disease, that is a pile of crap. In fact, high cholesterol is not the culprit in heart disease. In fact, most people that end up with heart disease, more than half of them have normal cholesterol. And only less than half of people with high cholesterol ever get heart disease. A heart surgeon who's done 5,000 heart surgeries, open heart surgeries, has said, I will tell you this. High cholesterol is not the culprit. Stress, sugar, inflammation, and oxidative stress is the culprit for heart disease. In fact, they said if you eat garbage, if you eat processed foods, trans fatty acids, you said, well, all my food that I get at the store says no trans fats. That's a pile of crap because it's the partially hydrogenated. All that stuff, that's the same thing in a different package. Anything you're getting in a package other than what Jordan Rubin has is basically trans fatty acids. Those things that are high in sugar count. They said what trans fats do, what sugar does to the cells is it's like taking sandpaper and rubbing it on your skin, but it's doing that to the inside of their arterial walls. You want to be at risk for heart disease, guess what? Begin to consume more sugar. Begin to consume processed foods. Begin to consume anything that's not raw.
That's why what Jordan does is so instrumental for us, because you, if you want to break and minimize stress, you need to make sure what you're putting on your body, the largest organ in your body, and what you're putting in your body is complementary to reducing the stress response. But here's what's interesting. When the spinal cord stretches, it releases nociceptors. When the spinal cord relaxes, it stops the stress response. But if calluses have formed over years' time, you have to remove that callus formation. This is what, there's a terminology in our society that's called pathology. How many of you have heard of pathology before? You go to the doctor and they say you have high blood pressure, they consider that pathology. If you have thyroid issues, blood pressure issues, cholesterol issues, MS, cancer, pathology. Do you understand what I'm talking about? What does pathology mean? It basically means your body has broken down and not doing what it's created to do. Does that make sense?
Yes.
If your blood pressure is not 120 over 80, they consider that not the norm. Therefore, it's pathology, meaning the body has broken down. Though our society in the medical community considers anything outside the norm of 120 over 80 with blood pressure as pathology, I'm in complete disagreement with the term pathology, simply because I believe we're fearfully, wonderfully made, bought with the price, and God doesn't create junk. He created our bodies to work. I believe a better term than pathology is, in fact, adaptive physiology. Adaptive physiology basically says this: your body will adapt physiologically to the environment that it's in. For instance, if we go to Denver, we get off a plane in Denver. All of you know that it's a higher altitude in Denver, correct?
Yes.
We get off a plane in Denver at a higher altitude. It's proven that a red blood cell count will increase. Why? So that we can get the blood cells, red blood cells carry oxygen, right? And so we need more oxygen to our brain. So I need the red blood cell count to increase so I can get more oxygen to my brain. Would you consider an increase in red blood cell count when you get off a plane in Denver to be pathology, the body broken, or simply adapting physiologically? If I'm running away from a tiger and my blood pressure is high, would you consider that pathology or adaptive physiology? I need my body to have high blood pressure if I'm running away from a tiger. I need my digestive system to shut off if I'm running away from a tiger. I need my immune system to shut off. Why? So it can focus my attention on getting away from the tiger and surviving. Yet we have a society right now that terms high blood pressure as pathology. We term thyroid issues, cholesterol issues, cancer, MS, you name it, as pathology. Therefore, if it's pathology, therefore, if your blood pressure is at 120 over 80, what do? You go to the doctor, they don't feel good. You go to the doctor and said, well, I just don't feel good. He puts a blood pressure cuff on your arm, determines that, guess what? You have high blood pressure, hypertension. So what does the doctor do? Gives you medication. And let's be honest, that medication will lower your blood pressure.
Lowers the numbers.
Absolutely. Well, I don't disagree with that. But 3 months later, you start to feel lousy. Go back to the doctor and you say, Doc, I just don't feel that well. First of all, he checks you out and determines that you actually have high blood pressure again. He says, well, your blood pressure is high. Well, first of all, Doc, why would my blood pressure be high? You put me on a blood pressure medication. Because they never address the cause of why the blood pressure was high in the first place. So what does the doctor do? Do they take you off the one medication? No, they actually give you another medication. I have people come to my office on 8 or 9 blood pressure medications. Friends, that is malpractice. That is ludicrous. That is the greatest way to kill yourself, because every drug has a side effect. Especially when you combine them together. That's like the oil light in your car coming on. You bring it to the gas station, the mechanic comes up and he says, can you do something for my oil light? And he says, well, I have a great solution for you. He takes a black piece of tape out of his pocket, puts it right over your oil light, and says, you're free to go. You won't even see the oil. You will never see the oil light again. What do you think of your mechanic? He's an idiot. The problem isn't the oil light. The problem is that the engine has that proper oil in it. We laugh at that because we don't do that, but every single time we take a pill, we're doing essentially the same thing. And I'm not telling someone to get off a medication. I'd never tell you to get off a medication. But if we continue to address the imbalances in chemistry in our body as pathology and not adaptive physiology, we've missed the boat. I've been saying that in my office for a number of years, giving that analogy of the oil light, and then all of a sudden about six months ago, the engine light in my car came on. I go, oh, Lord, have mercy. So I called up one of my good buddies who was a car
you know, the car lot, and I said, hey man, can you do something for this oil light, or for this engine light? And he says, I'll go over to so-and-so, and they'll take care of you. And so I go over there, and they said, Dr. Pete, you know, we knew you'd be coming, and so they hooked up my car to the computer and opened up my hood and hooked it up to the computer, and they're looking at it for a few minutes and took it out, shut my lid, and came around and said, Dr. Pete, you're free to go. I said, really? That quick? He goes, yeah. I go, do I owe you anything? He goes, oh, no. I go, well, what is it? He goes, well, actually, we couldn't find anything, so we just turned it off. And so I said, okay. So I left, and about two blocks later, my car died. And then I thought to myself, this guy is truly an idiot. Because you can't just turn the oil light on. You can't just cover up the symptoms. You can't just continue to live your life any way you want and think it's going to be okay. It just doesn't work that way. Our bodies are the temple of God. He said they're fearfully, wonderfully made, bought with a Christ price. It's the foundation of everything that you do in your life. If you don't have your health, guess what? You don't have anything. I'll be the first one to tell you that Jordan Rubin is the greatest natural health expert in the world, with the desire to get you healthy and keep you healthy. Having the largest chiropractic wellness clinic in the world right now, with people coming from 19 different states, 5 different countries, guess what? My desire is to be an advocate for people to help them get healthy and stay healthy. There's no better opportunity to partner with Jordan Rubin, myself, Dr. Barrett, Dr. Josh Axe, than with Beyond Again. I can't hire you all in my office. I don't need you. I actually wouldn't want some of you in my office because you don't have a chiropractic degree. But do you know that we can change the life of this country, and I can do it so much more effectively through you and with you than I can on my own? Justin was the one that began to show me the impact that a network marketing system can have. Because when I am an asset to you, you know people that I will never be able to reach. And if I'm going to truly make an impact in this world, then I need you and you and you and you and you. And one puts 1,000 flat, 2 10,000 flat. How much more effective can we change this world together? With your sphere of influence and your sphere of influence and your sphere of influence, together we can truly change this world. When it comes to a health percent, there's nothing greater on this planet right now, from a health perspective, than what is being presented right now. The number one supplement company in America right now is Garden of Life, developed by the mind that was given from God from New York Times bestselling author Jordan Rubin, who wrote the Maker's Diet, sold 3 million copies in America, and sold it now for $100-some million, put $65 million into Beyond Organic, and does not take a dime for it. Come on. I don't know any other network marketing company in the world that's not in it just for the money. Jordan Rubin has not taken one dime from Beyond Organic. Why? Because he's more interested in taking care of the fatherless and the widows and feeding 1 million people by 2020, the healthiest food on the planet. Why? Because he knows this, that the fruit of this life, anything I do to store up on this earth, moth and rust will destroy. But everything that he stores up in heaven, moth and rust cannot destroy. It's about an eternal harvest. It's about eternal fruit. If you want to know, in all transparency, what Jordan Rubin is about, he's about bearing fruit for the kingdom of God. He doesn't care about his pocketbook. I've been in his house many times in Palm Beach Gardens. He has like a 30,000 square foot home. It's not like, it just seems like that to my 4-year-old. It's just like huge. It's massive in Palm Beach Gardens. It's one of the most beautiful homes I've ever been around. It's probably worth millions and millions and millions of dollars. He sold it. He was willing to give it to someone. And he's now living in a 900 square foot home on the ranch in Missouri. Because him and his wife's desire is to take care of the fatherless and the widows, to win this world to Christ, to feed this country, the healthiest food on the planet, not for his own. I told you at the beginning, I'd rather surround myself with not people that are into money, surround myself with people that are strong where I'm weak, surround myself with people that are humble, teachable, and passionate for Jesus Christ. That's why I'm involved with Jordan Rubin, not because of the money. I'm doing projects at the UN right now, and people say, well, the UN's pagan. Absolutely it's pagan, but I'm earning my right so I can go and stand in their countries on a stage in front of 100,000 people and then not kill me. This world needs water. This world needs food. This world needs clothing. This world needs connectivity. And so I believe that God's raising up the Josephs of this world to infiltrate the Egypts of this world. Why? So that we can earn our right in people's lives. One of the greatest ways to earn our right in this society right now is meet the most basic needs of humankind, their food, what they eat. Everybody eats. Not everyone uses a supplement, but everyone eats. Are you in agreement?
Yeah.
You can go on cleanses all day long, fasts all week long, but guess what? When it comes down, you're going to have to eat. And why not put the best food in your body and get it paid for? To be able to encourage my patients, guess what? You're going to go to Whole Foods, and Whole Foods allows genetically modified food right now. The number one Whole Foods nutritional grocery store, healthy grocery store in the country is now allowing genetically modified foods. What a pile of crap.
And they're labeled organic.
And they're labeled organic. And then I can spray pesticides on my food as a farmer if I feel like it's a risk to everything else. Is anything real? I'll tell you what. New York Times bestselling author Jordan Rubin, the fruit of his life speaks for itself. The Word of God says this: you will know someone by their fruit. Not the lip service, not what they say. I can sit here and I can tell you anything I want to tell you, but ultimately at the end of the day, you're going to look at the fruit of my life. I don't care what a pastor tells me on the stage. I'm going to see how they live their life behind closed doors. We will be known by our fruit. When it comes to business, have you created a billion-dollar business? Has anyone here created a billion-dollar company so far? Yet if you want to be a billionaire, one thing I know is that you need to hang out with billionaires. If I want to be successful financially, I don't hang around with people that just filed bankruptcy over and over again. If I want to have a successful marriage, I need to be around people that have a successful marriage, not that are getting divorced, cheating on their spouse, right? That's not someone that you want to have a... You want to have a successful marriage, surround yourself with individuals that have had a successful marriage. You want to do good financially, surround yourself with people that know how to steward financially as good stewards over their finances. I think TK likes to bring me to places. Why? Because you like to surround yourself with individuals that are strong where you're weak so that they can iron sharpens iron with each other, right? Brothers in Christ, sisters in Christ coming together so that we can help each other grow. Hey, you want to go into business with me, Jordan Rubin, or whatever? Let's just partner together, not thinking of ourselves more highly than we ought to think, right? Humbling ourselves in the mighty hand of God. In due season, He will lift us up, not into us, but into Him. How awesome is it, though, that you have the best nutrition, best foods on the planet with a business mind like Jordan Rubin? He always already has the fruit that says he knows how to create a billion-dollar company. I have individuals that come and they don't pay their bills. They're spinning their wheels for 20 years. Oh, I don't know about Jordan Rubin. You know, I don't know that whole... Network marketing, trust me, if anyone's been against network marketing, it's been me with all the people that have come to my office over the years. I'll tell you this. There's nobody I'd rather partner with in business and health than Jordan Rubin. Nobody. I want to partake of the grace in Jordan Rubin's life. I don't want to be Jordan Rubin. You'll be the first one to tell you that you don't want to be Jordan Rubin. You don't want to be Dr. Pete. You couldn't handle being me, and I couldn't handle being you. But how cool is it that I can partake in the grace in your life and experience the fruit from your life just by coming in unison, in agreement with you, and coming in partnership with you? You want to be in partnership with Justin Jacobs, who has won a great business mind, an incredible business mind and marketing mind, come in and receive the fruit of Jordan's life and Dr. Axe's life and my life, then guess what? This is the way you can do it. Does that make sense? When it comes to a health perspective, the body works based on the brains that they communicate with the body at a cellular level. When the cell vibrates, it allows the gene to express itself the way it's supposed to. The sterile cleanse in the cultured way that has a perfect balance of sodium and potassium allows the cell to detoxify itself and replenish it and hydrate it. Why? What's the significance of that so that the cell can maintain its vibration? Did you know if that cell gets clogged because of stress? Because of that stress response, that vibration begins to lose its, that cell loses its vibration. And if the cell loses its vibration, it becomes abnormal. And so if the cell becomes toxic or deficient in nutrients, the cellular vibration is altered, affecting genetic expression. You never have to worry about getting cancer. In a society right now, when you walk into the churches of this world, and the pastors are afraid of cancer, the medical doctors are afraid of cancer, the chiropractors are afraid of cancer, no one knows how to get cancer, everyone's worried about if they're going to get it or someone else is going to get it, and how do you treat it if you truly do get it? Do you know that you don't have to be worried about any of that stuff? Because the body was created in the image and likeness of God Himself. We are fearfully, wonderfully made. The body was created to work, if it's doing what it was created to do. I tell people all the time, I'm not your healer, but I'm here to facilitate your body's ability to do what God created it to do. We can do that together. You do not have to be a chiropractor or the world's leading natural health expert to change this world in a positive way. You yourself, doesn't matter if you haven't had a job for 20 years, you can partner together, partake in the grace on Jordan's life, my life, Justin's life, and we can impact this world together because you know people that I don't know. And you know people that others don't know, and together we can change this world and partake in the fruit together from that life. You don't have to know everything about health. That's why He's made it very easy with systems and procedures to replicate this business. So you can basically say, hey, come in here, doctor, come in here, Justin. Get on our Kingdom Business Life radio program. Come, listen to that. Go listen to old podcasts. Every radio show I have Jordan Rubin on, Dr. Josh Apps, Dr. Baird on the health sides. I have Justin on the business side. I have people talking about finances. I have people talking about biblical principles of success. Every week, old podcasts. Go there. It's amazing. We're just entered into our ninth city across the world. They think it's going to be is in mainstream markets, Christian markets. They're eating it up. They think that we'll be in, over the next few years, 400 markets across America. Only by the grace of God will it. But you want to surround yourself with people that are strong when you're weak. Get on a call, our synergy call every Sunday night. Just 30 minutes. You want to start your week off right? We share with you information that you're not seeing, hearing in the media about how to get healthy and stay healthy. Then we empower you with biblical principles of success. And then I pray over everybody and your families going into that week that you have breakthrough in your life. There's cards on the back. Get on that call. Everyone that gets on this call is totally blown away. It's changing their life. We have amazing things, a financial breakthrough, health miracles, people's ears open, just crazy stuff taking place. And then being encouraged. As you go into that week, you can go in that week with great freedom. Break the stress response. Allow the body to communicate at a cellular level so that cell vibrates, expresses the DNA properly. You begin to consume more sugar, more processed foods, guess what? It increases the stress response. And then what happens is this. A neuroplastic pattern develops. Neuroplasticity develops. That keeps the body in a stress response. Do you know that when we begin to incorporate the proper foods, begin to make sure that we get our mind renewed in the Word of God, that we actually create a healthy neuroplastic pattern? That allows the body to adapt and recover properly. So here's the thing. I want the body to adapt physiologically, but I want it to recover. When it stops recovering, it becomes consumed, and that's why you get cancer. You don't understand. It's things that happened in my aunt's life years ago. When the only mentality was, well, I'm just going to take a pill for everything. That I can eat whatever I want and just take a pill and everything's going to be okay. The Word of God said, do not be deceived. I'm not mocking. You will reap what you sow. But praise God for His grace. Praise God that God can come in and intercede and turn a situation around because He's a miracle-working God. There's nothing too hard for Him. He's a supernatural God. So we come to the Lord and say, Lord, I repent. And then say, Lord, teach me how to be a better steward. That's why Jordan's so passionate. That's why I'm so passionate, because our bodies are the foundation of everything that we do. You don't have your healthy, what do you have? How do you fulfill the call of God in your life if you're stuck in a hospital bed, if you're stuck on 1,000 medications? Knoxville, Tennessee, where I live, is the number of prescribed city in America at 18.3 drugs per person per day.
Oh my God.
There's more hospitals per capita than anywhere else in the world, and there's also more fast food and restaurants per capita than anywhere else in America as well. You wonder. Because everyone wants a quick fix. We don't want to steward over the temple of God. And then we wonder why we're reaping these consequences. Because whatever man sows, he shall reap. But if you begin to sow healthy and make a healthy investment, though you might not notice it tomorrow, you will. And if we sow and water good seeds of health, guess what? We're going to reap the benefits of it. Quit putting the garbage on your skin. Quit eating everything that you want to.
Oh, I'm just going to live my life anywhere I want. I have a relative of mine that just says, oh, all she drinks is Diet Coke and eats junk. And wonders why she throws up because she takes all these medications on an empty stomach and it doesn't hydrate. And you, oh, I'm like 55 years of age. I'm doing great. I'm completely healthy. Why is it that one out of every two men or whatever, three women is supposed to be diagnosed with cancer this year, and we have a society that actually thinks we're healthy? Number one person, it's crazy. The greatest country, nation in the world that spends more money on healthcare than anywhere else in the world is the sickest nation in the world. Do you think we maybe missed it? Insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, expecting different results. It's time that we change this society, change this community, and we're going to do it one person at a time, partnering together. One plus a thousand, like two tenths of a thousand. Like, can you imagine what we can do together? But let's make sure that the body can do what it was created to do. And reduce that, minimize that stress, break that stress response, and watch that body literally turn itself around. Do you know this? That if someone treats your symptoms, studies have said, good luck.
Yeah.
Because of no correlation, just because you feel good that you're healthy. But they said this, if you break a harmful neurological pattern that's preventing the body from adapting to recovering to stress, then get this, it's impossible for you not to get well. Did you know that we can recreate how the body functions by making healthy choices with the food that we eat, the air that we breathe, and those things that we're doing? Surround yourself with individuals that are strong when you're weak. We can change this world. Yes, ma'am.
I'm just wondering, you talked about the callus. How do you get rid of the callus? The
biggest thing is I have to begin to incorporate foods that are healthy, make sure my skin cures the way it's supposed to, and then if it becomes severe, then that's why people come to us from all over the world to break that harmful neurological pattern. I've done a lot with Jordan Rubin. We've taken care of a lot of celebrity figures around the country. And what we do is we incorporate, we get that body. See, here's the thing, in a stress response, the body becomes toxic and deficient, right? That's what we talk about. So I remove the toxicity and I add the sufficiency. Okay? So I remove the toxicity, the suero cleanse, okay? Milk thistle for the liver, the turmeric. Do you know that turmeric says that it stops initiation, promotion, metastasis of cancer? It goes and breaks down a cell and takes out the gene. And so you remove the toxicity, and then you add the sufficiency. You remove the toxicity from all your skincare products, and you add the sufficiency. You remove the toxicity from all these bath care products and soaps and everything, and you add the sufficiency. How do you add the sufficiency? You add good, healthy snacks into your life, right? You add the grass-fed beef. You add the amasi and the good dairy. Dairy in our society right now is more detrimental to you than gluten is. So he got the cattle from somewhere else. He says, so let's remove the toxicity and the junk that we're putting in and add the sufficiency, add the probiotics, add the vitamin D, add the good essential fats. And a society that says remove fats for heart disease, where he says, actually, if you look at let's add good, healthy fats, grass-fed, green-fed beef, beyond organic, not just, hey, I didn't add anything to it, but there's no sufficiency in the product. Beyond organic means we remove the toxicity and we add the sufficiency, so that means everything that you're getting is not depleted in those nutrients. And then if you get in crisis situation and they say you're not going to make it, and there's serious callus formation, we don't change this. Everyone on the planet needs to do this. Now everyone on the planet needs to do this. No matter who you are, no matter if you're on 1,000 medications or no medications. That's the one thing that's certain. There's not another supplement, there's not another multi-level marketing company on the planet that I can say that with. I know the owners of all these multi-level marketing companies, good friends of mine. And I can honestly tell you this. I teach continuing education to doctors all over the world, and I can tell you this. There's no company out there that unequivocally can say, you need this to survive. And I'll tell you this. Everyone eats. Are you in agreement? Does everyone eat?
Yes.
And if you're going to put something in your body, why not put the best in your body? You say, I don't have the money for it. A few dollars more
and know that you're actually putting something in that's not detrimental for you, and in a system that allows you to get your food for free. If I'm in a situation where I have no money, I'm not healthy, what does everyone want? They want their health and they want money.
Health and wealth.
Right?
No.
So if I'm in a situation where I have no money and I don't have proper health, then don't you think it would be a little bit wise to surround yourself with individuals that know how to make money and know how to get healthy? I don't care if you don't have any money, you still eat. There's nobody, no matter how broke you are, that doesn't eat. Therefore, how cool would it be to want the best food on the planet and get it for free? Whether that's a $400 a month budget or a $3,000 a month budget. Listen to me, if that's all it was for you, you didn't want to make millions with this company. You just want to simply get your grocery bill for free every month and know it was free. What does that take? Introduce a few people. Say, I don't know how to articulate that duck like Justin is. Then bring them here. You say, well, I've talked to a few people before and they just don't seem to want to come. Then be a shameless, persistent widow and keep knocking on the door because you will change their life.
It's about 5 months to get a yes, isn't it?
I'm not interested in wasting my time. But I'm interested in changing your life. I'm not interested in being your best friend. If you want me in my life, it's to change your life. That's it. That's what you need me in your life for. To be a blessing in your life, to refresh you in your life. And I can unequivocally say, if you consume these products, you're the healthiest on the planet. If you partner with Jordan Rubin, there's no better businessman that I know of young entrepreneurs than him. Work.
Doing good?
Doing good.
You don't get that at every one of our weekly meetings. So it's an honor to have Dr. Pete here, and you can see the passion behind what he stands for and who he is. And so when he calls you and says, I just landed on the biggest thing of my career, it's easy to sit up and take notice, right? Even if it's an uncomfortable industry for you, even if you're not into the health and the nutrition, you know, like I was. Everybody I registered, I didn't really register anybody that was into health and nutrition. And people I registered were into the business side of it. Number one most explosive industry in our country right now, just about to hit critical mass. But, you know, and that really brings me to our key factor number 7, and that is the fact that it's Jordan Rubin, right? I mean, the guy literally, when he founded Garden of Life, like within 5 years, it was named one of America's fastest growing companies on the Inc. 500 list and Entrepreneur Magazine. Today, it's the number one supplement company in the world. It's only a 12-year-old company, gang. Did $1 billion in sales in its first 10 years. This guy's not only a nutrition genius, the number one health expert in the world, he's a business icon. He built a $1 billion company. There's not many people that can claim that, right? Increased 50 times in value over 12 years. So, man, this is a guy I want to be in business with. And here's the key to the whole thing. Remember at the beginning of the talk, I said, hey, when Jordan got healed by eating natural food, he wanted to know, how do we bring this food to America? But he couldn't figure out how to bring food like this to the masses back then. So he did the next best thing in his mind, which was find a supplement company. Gang, that was his backup plan, right? That was the temporary solution while he figured out how to do what he's truly passionate about. And that is bring foods and beverages. He's always believed that supplements are good, but should be in addition to the nutrition we're getting from our foods. That's our source of nutrition, not the pill and the supplement. The supplement should be in addition to as needed, right? If he did that with his backup temporary plan, what is he going to do with this? You tracking with me here? And that's really what was the icing on the cake for me. Thank you.